إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. Indeed, all praise is due to Allah, we praise Him. Seek His aid and ask His forgiveness. We seek refuge in Allah from the evils of ourselves and from the evils of our actions. Whom sabar Allah guides, none can lead astray. And whom sabar Allah leads astray, none can guide. I bear witness that there is none worthy of worship except for Allah alone, having no partner. And I bear witness that Muhammad is a slave and His messenger. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu taqullaha haqqa tuqatih wa la tamutunna illa wa antum muslimun. O you who believe, fear Allah as He should be feared. Die not except in a state of Islam, with full and complete submission to Allah. Ya ayyuha nasu taqoo rabbakum alladhi khalaqakum min nafsin wahida wa khalaqa minha zawjaha wa batha minhuma rijalan kathiran wa nisaa wa taqullaha alladhi tasa'aluna bihi wal arham inna allaha kana alaykum raqiba. O mankind, be dutiful to your Lord who created you from Adam, single person, and from him he created his wife, Hawa, and from them both he created many men and women, and fear Allah through whom you demand your mutual rights, and do not cut the relations of your relatives. Surely Allah is ever on all watch over you. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu taqullaha wa qulu qawlan sadida yuslih lakum a'malakum wa yaghfir lakum dhunubakum وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ فَقَدْ فَازَ فَوْزًا عَظِيمًا. O you who believe, keep your duty to Allah and speak always the truth. He will direct you to do righteous good deeds and He will forgive your sins. And whosoever obeys Allah and His Messenger has indeed achieved a great achievement. And that is, he will be made to enter paradise and he will be saved from the hellfire. And what an achievement. أما بعد, to proceed, فَإِنَّ أَصْدَقَ الْحَدِيثِ كِتَابُ اللَّهِ. The best of talks is the Quran, the book of Allah. Wa ahsan al-hadi, hadi Muhammad. And the best of guidance is the guidance of His Messenger Muhammad, may peace and blessings be upon him. Wa inna sharra al-umuri muhdathatuha. And verily the most evil of all matters in Islam are the ones innovated. Fa inna kulla muhdathatin bid'ah. For every newly innovated matter in Islam is an innovation. Wa kulla bid'atin dalalah. And every innovation in Islam is a misguidance. Wa kulla dalalatin fi an-nar. And every misguidance will lead to the hellfire. The Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala addressing the people saying, Fafirru ila Allah. Flee to Allah. The believer will flee from Allah to Allah. As for the wicked and the wretched and the disbeliever, where is he going to flee? He's fleeing from Allah to his own gods. And fleeing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only way to gain success and happiness, to guarantee that you are happy in this world. When you flee to Allah Azza wa Jal in your time of your rejoice or in your time of calamities. And by fleeing to Allah Azza wa Jal, there are things to be done. One of them is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, illa tansuruhu faqad nasarahu Allah. If you don't champion him, for already Allah had championed him. We need to champion Allah Azza wa Jal. We must, for fleeing to Allah and getting happiness, to make sure that we love our Prophet more than ourselves, more than our property and money, more than our families. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, we need to know about him. And from those things that make you to love the Prophet of Allah is knowing some of the miracles that Allah Azza wa Jal had given to his Prophet Muhammad, may peace and blessings be upon him. Ibadallah, knowing the fact that our prophets, they have miracles, it will increase your iman. And Allah wants you to increase your iman. وَيَزْدَادَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِيمَانًا. In order for those people who are believers to increase their iman. Also, when you call people to Islam, what is the point of you calling them to Islam and the ambassador of Islam is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, yet you don't know anything about his miracles? The miracles will let these people to believe that this man is from God, and that's the miracle. The miracle, a supernatural act, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants only and only to the prophets. And those are challengeable. You can't challenge them, unchallengeable. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He aids the prophet with a miracle so that the people will believe that he's from Allah. All the prophets that we have, all of them, they had specific miracles. Those miracles, ibadallah, if anybody claims to have them, he's a liar. So we need to know about the miracles of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And before I go ahead to describe about the Prophet's miracle, I need to make sure you understand the difference between a miracle, which is a supernatural act, or a khawariq, or karamat, or istidraj, which are supernatural things, but they are not for prophets. What does that mean? We have in the history, documented with authentic chain, some of the miracles, or supernatural things I should say, had taken place on the hands of other than prophets. Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu, while he was addressing the people in the khutbah, just like I'm doing at the moment, out of context, he just said, Ya Sariya al-Jabal, O Sariya, mountain, go to the mountain. Sariya is the name of a person whom he himself, Umar al-Khattab, had sent to lead a group of an army to meet the enemies. So when he descended the pulpit and after he prayed the Jumu'ah, some of the companions, Ali ibn Abi Talib, approached him. Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, what was that all about? He asked, what? He said, Ya Sari al-Jabal. He said, I can't remember. A word that he had said, it was out of context, 2 months afterwards, or a month afterwards, when the army had arrived, led by Sariya, approached Umar, he said, Jazakallahu khayran, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen. We've heard your voice in the mountains. Had it been for that voice, would have been in the ambush which the enemies had laid down for us. Straight away we went to the mountain. This is a karama Allah had given to Umar al-Khattab, that his voice had traveled all the way to that place. And that's, by the way, authentic, according to the scholars like Sheikh Al-Albani rahimahullah. Not only that, we have also supernatural things, karama, something that Allah designates his believers, a noble thing, something which is a blessing from Allah Azza wa Jal. If we just go to Ma'sat al-Raji', a place between Usfan and Mecca. I don't know if you know Usfan where it is, but it's not far away from Mecca. This place was called al-Raji'. On the year 4 after Hijrah, some tribes like Adal, Al-Qara, they sent to the Prophet of Allah to send them people from the Muslims to teach them their religion. It was just few months since the Battle of Uhud, where the Muslims had lost 70 martyrs. But the Prophet of Allah was keen to spread the da'wah. So he was not really sort of worried, should I send them or not? Maybe they're going to be killed, they're going to be ambushed. He sent 10 learned companions to teach the people Islam. And they were led by Asib ibn Thabit radiallahu anhu. They head those 10 companions towards the place called Al-Raji'. Between Usfan and Mecca. But the tribe of Banu Lihyan got 200 fighters. And the treachery, it proves to be the fate of these people. So they surrounded the companions. The companions went to the top of a mountain. First karama, Asib ibn Thabit, he says, O Lord, convey the news of what is taking place to the Prophet of Allah. Prophet of Allah, straight away, he knows what took place. There was no mobile at that time. There was no pigeon to carry the news. It's only Allah. First karama. Allah fulfilled the dua of Asim. And now they said to them, surrender. We'll do nothing. Asim, he said, no way, we will not surrender. 10 against 200. They were outnumbered. Before Asim ibn Thabit is to be martyred in the sake of Allah, second karama, says, O Lord, today I am protecting your religion. Protect my flesh. Asib ibn Thabit, during the Battle of Uhud, he had killed one of the kuffar. The mother of that person, she vowed that she will drink wine in his skull, in his head. So when seven of the companions were killed, along with them Asim, the army of the Kuffar from Banu Lihyan approached the body of Asim to take the head, to decapitate or cut off the head, drink wine and give it to that woman in order to fulfill her vow. They tried to approach. Allah sends swarm of hornets, bees, large bees that couldn't approach his body. That's a karama, ibadallah. Three are left. Abdullah ibn Tariq, Zayd ibn Dathina, Khubayb ibn Adi. They were surrendered. And as soon as they laid down their arms, treachery again. They put handcuffs in their hands, tied them up, and dragged them to kill them in Mecca, and to sell them to those who want them, to take revenge from them. Abdullah ibn Tariq refused. He was killed straight away. Now Khubayb ibn Adi was purchased by the family of Banu al-Harith. Banu al-Harith, led by al-Harith, he was killed on the hands of Khubayb in the battle of Uhud. So the family of al-Harith purchased him in order to take revenge and kill him. He is in the house of Banu al-Harith. Tomorrow he's going to be assassinated, he's going to be killed. But outside the haram, the wife of al-Harith, she says, "By Allah, I have seen him eating from a bunch of grapes, and there is not a single fruit in the whole of Mecca." That's a karama, ya ibadallah. Karama Allah blessed that companion with, ibadallah. But this karama or this supernatural act might take place on the hand of somebody who does not claim that there is no God worthy of worship except for Allah alone. Ad-Dajjal, the greatest of all liars. Allah gives him powers. By his finger, he would say to the cloud, "Come," and would rain. Not to rain for those who do not follow him. All the treasures will follow him like the swarm of bees. That's an istidraj. Meaning, Allah is giving you the go ahead. If you want to follow him, then you will be led to hellfire. But ibadallah, the difference is between miracle and karama is the following way. That is number one. The miracle is only for prophets, nobody else. The miracles, Allah challenges the people to bring something like it. Whereas the karama, no. The miracle is for the benefit of everybody. Whereas the karama, for the person himself. The miracle, Allah commands the prophet to show it to the people. Whereas the karama is for yourself and not commanded to show it to the people. The miracle proves that he's a prophet. Something you taking place to you as a karama, you cannot say, "I am a righteous." Look, I had a dream and the dream came true, and that's a karama, it must be a righteous person. No, it is not the case. The miracle comes at the command of the prophet, be, and that it is. As for the karama, it only comes by the excellence or the virtues or the blessings of the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it is not at your command. That's the difference between the miracle and the karama and the istidraj. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وَعَلَى مَنْ تَبِعَ هُدَاهُمْ إِلَى يَوْمِ الدِّينِ. Miracles of the prophets are suitable to their time, suitable to the people. Musa alayhi salam, at his time, sorcery was prevalent. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala challenged those sorcerers, those magicians, with Musa alayhi salam's staff. He threw it and it became a proper snake. That's why straight away the sorcerers fell on their faces. They said, "Cannot be, this is something sort of deception. It has to be from divine." They believed in the God of Musa alayhi salam. At the time of Isa alayhi salam, medicine is prevalent. Doctors, they could claim that they cure lots of things. Allah sends Isa alayhi salam. He could heal the leper. He could give sight to the born child, blind born child, and also give life to the dead by the permission of Allah azza wa jal. All these prophets have been given miracles suitable to their people to challenge them. But where are the miracles of those prophets? The staff of Musa alayhi salam is not there. And also Isa alayhi salam to perform those miracles in front of us is not there. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is as an everlasting miracle. And that is the Quran. Why Allah Azza wa Jal, he has sent the Quran as a miracle in order to prove to the people after the death of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that the Prophet of Allah is a Prophet of Allah. You are, when you're reading the Quran, holding a miracle, ibadallah. This is the miracle of the Quran, words from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whom Allah Azza wa Jal had guaranteed to be his words, as we're going to see. Ibadallah, at the time of the people of Quraysh, people, they were eloquent speakers, poets, like Shakespeare's. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala challenged them with this Quran, bring something like it. And the kuffar of Quraysh, they were wondering, what should they do in order to divert people from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? He was in Mecca, people coming to the season of Hajj, Prophet of Allah is approaching them, making da'wah to them. What should we tell the people? One of them, he said, let's say that he's a poet and whatever he's producing is poetry. They said to him, you have no common sense. That means you're crazy. These people are Arabs. They know that this Quran is not poetry. So it's something else. They knew it is cannot be challenged. They couldn't challenge it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said to them, قال فأتوا بحديث مثله إن كنتم صادقين. Bring something like it, the whole Quran. Then the challenge goes a bit less. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says to them, قُلْ فَأْتُوا بِعَشْرِ سُوَرٍ مِثْلِهِ مُفْتَرَيَاتٍ وَادْعُوا مَنِ اسْتَطَعْتُمْ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. Bring 10 chapters like it. Then that challenge goes less as well. أَمْ يَقُولُونَ افْتَرَاهُ. Do they say that he had forged it? فَأْتُوا بِسُورَةٍ مِثْلِهِ. Let you bring a surah, one chapter, like it. وَادْعُوا مَنِ اسْتَطَعْتُمْ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. And call beside Allah whoever you want, if you are truthful. The challenge even was repeated, not just in Mecca, even in Medina. وَإِنْ كُنْتُمْ فِي رَيْبٍ مِمَّا نَزَّلْنَا عَلَىٰ عَبْدِنَا فَأْتُوا بِسُورَةٍ مِنْ مِثْلِهِ. So Allah Azza wa Jal, he said, if you are in doubt of what we have revealed to our slave Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, bring a chapter like this. وَادْعُوا مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ وَادْعُوا شُهَدَاءَكُمْ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ إِنْ كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. And call your witnesses between, beside Allah, if you are truthful. فإن لم تفعلوا ولن تفعلوا فاتقوا النار التي وقودها الناس والحجارة أعدت للكافرين. If you're not going to be able, and you will never be able to bring like it, then prepare yourself for the fire whose the fuel of it is men and stone. Ibadallah, this is the Quran that you're holding, a miracle from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The words of Allah is between your eyes. So for the one who's reading the Quran, where his heart, subhanallah, shakes as soon as he reads the words of Allah, he's responding. This is the Quran that talks about the story, for those who did not know anything about the story of Adam alayhi salam, how he was created. Nuh alayhi salam with the ark. Ibrahim alayhi salam with his people. Musa alayhi salam against the magicians, the sorcerers. Dawood and Sulaiman alayhi salam with the jinn and how they used to speak with the birds. All of these stories in the Quran. The Quran, not only that, talks about things that happened in the future when the Quran was revealed. Tabbat yada Abi Lahab wa tab. Woe to the hands of Abu Lahab, the uncle of the Prophet. He was a kafir, and the ayat was sent while he was alive. Sayasla naran dhata lahab. He will go to hell. Abu Lahab, he could have, just for the sake of putting doubts in the hearts of the believers, he could have just come to them and say, do you believe that Quran is from God? Yes, we believe. Do you believe that Quran cannot make mistake? Yes, we believe. Doesn't say that I'm going to go to hell? Yes, it does. So, well, okay. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. He never said it. He died as a kafir. So the surah doomed for him to be a kafir while he's alive. In the Battle of Badr, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he had confirmed with companions, and they've agreed to go ahead and fight. And the fight was not set or prepared before. So Allah Azza wa Jal, he sends the verse. سَيُهْزَمُ الْجَبْعُ وَيُوَلُّونَ الدُّبُرُ. They will flee and show their backs. And the Prophet of Allah said, إِنِّي أَرَى مَصَارِعَ الْقَوْمِ. Verily, I could see where the people are going to be killed. Each one who's going to be killed, where is going to be killed. That was before the Battle of Badr. Companions, they had the confirmation. They're going to have the winning even though they didn't start the battle. And that's from the future, ibadallah. Quran of yours talks about the stage. How the person is performed and created in the womb of his mother. No way at the time of the Prophet of Allah. Without this microscope, which was only invented about 70, 80 years ago, they would find out how the baby was formed. Only 150 years ago, they used to say, that is first flesh and then bones. But Allah said in the Quran, Ya ayyuha an-nas, in kuntum fi raybin min al-ba'th. O people, if you are in doubt of what we have revealed, of revelation, fa'inna khalaqnakum. Verily, we have created you min turab, from dust, thumma min nutfa, then the clot, thumma min alaqa, then a cling. Wallahi, the alaqa in itself is a miracle. That's a alaqa, hanging, because alaqa, suspended, hanging to the cord of the belly, of the cord of the woman. That is something that cannot be seen. قال ثم خلقنا العلقة مضغة. So then the علقة became مضغة. من علقة مخلقة مضغة مخلقة وغير مخلقة. That is chewed and unchewed. And you look at it, subhanAllah. And the علقة also a leech. And the baby at that stage looks like a leech. And then he said, ثم, that is, we made him into عظاما. فكسونا العظام لحما. After that, the stage of bones, then the bones was covered with the flesh. Keith Moore, a scholar, he is Abu al-Ajinnah, the father. He's the greatest man regarding the womb and the fetus and all of that. His book was translated to more than 10 languages. It is taught into the university until today. He had to admit when he read the Quran that this cannot be from anybody. It has to be from divine. I don't know what he had embraced Islam or not, but he had put into his book, that is the book of the womb and what had takes place, with the addition of what Quran had said. So he added what the Quran had said, because he had said, verily nobody can describe what takes place in the womb and the stage of the baby better than what the Quran had described. This is a miracle from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ibadallah. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى لي ولكم الثبات وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
استووا also feet by feet, shoulder by shoulder, leave no gaps. Allahu Akbar. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله
الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. هل أتاك حديث الغاشية وجوه يومئذ خاشعة عاملة ناصبة تصلى نارا حامية تسقى من عين آنية ليس لهم طعام إلا من ضريع لا يسمن ولا يغني من جوع وجوه يومئذ ناعمة لسعيها راضية في جنة عالية لا تسمع فيها لاغية فيها عين جارية فيها سرر مرفوعة وأكواب موضوعة ونمارق مصفوفة وزرابي مبثوثة أفلا ينظرون إلى الإبل كيف خلقت وإلى السماء كيف رفعت وإلى الجبال كيف نصبت وإلى الأرض كيف سطحت فذكر إنما أنت مذكر لست عليهم بمسيطر إلا من تولى وكفر فيعذبه الله العذاب الأكبر إن إلينا إيابهم ثم إن علينا حسابهم. الله أكبر.